Hey guys, well, you asked for it, so here you go. A few of our favorite reasons to adopt a calico cat. And as we say that, Maya turns her back on us. How rude.
Because we're being too loud. And she's trying to nap. Right, first and foremost, I think the first thing that needs to be mentioned is that calicos are not a breed of cats. They don't technically exist.
But she's right there.
In a way that they're not a recognized breed, they're actually a color combination. It's like a tortoise shell is not a breed of cats, it's a color code of the fur. So people keep saying, I want a calico, referring to a specific breed, but that's not actually true. You can get a calico in a variation of different breeds. So you can basically get calico colors in different breeds of cats, which is fantastic because that means that you can choose a cat breed that works for you and has the personality traits that you want out of a cat, and then you could get a calico within that breed if you like calico cats as well. So you could have a Maine Coon calico, you could have an American Shorthair calico. I don't think there's such a thing as a Siamese calico, but there are definitely a lot of different breeds, if you do your research, that have the calico color combination. And so you can choose the cat you like and get the color combination you want. It's also important to know that calicos are actually, the color combination itself is very, very old. They have portraits of it in pyramids and so on in
It's one of those ancient Egyptian cats. Worship them.
So they definitely have been around for a very long time. So it's not one of the newer combinations that was man-made. It's a combination that's been out there for a very long time.
Well, it kind of leads into this point because you can't breed a calico cat.
So the color combination is a genetic mutation. Very similarly to how Siamese points appear on a Siamese. So a calico, to have that combination of colors, so basically you can't plan the calico color combination. Even if you have a calico mom, you don't necessarily have to have a calico baby. So it's basically, if in your litter you have a calico, it's kind of like a miracle cat because you can never plan for it. So you're always lucky if you have one that pops up in your litter. So it's a completely unplanned color combination. And I think that's really awesome because it makes them so unique.
And as the next point, one of their most appealing thing is their multitude of color combinations. Well, it's always three colors. That's what calico means. Calicos are always three color cats.
And to qualify as a calico, to clear up that confusion, a tortoise shell is usually also three colors. But to qualify as a calico, the main color needs to be white. So you'll see Maya is mostly white, and then she has some ginger in her and some black, and you can actually see in her color, in her fur, that she also has stripes. So her black is actually quite stripy, but if you look at her whole body, white is the predominant color in her, and that's what makes a calico versus a tortoiseshell. But they do come in different variations. You can have more white, you can have less white, you can have more ginger, you can have less ginger, you can have browns, blacks. They really come in different patterns, and it's really, really fun.
Then the next one is, if you do have a calico, there's a 99.9% chance that it will be a female. That's just one of the part of the mutation, I suppose. And along with that, a fun fact, if you have a male calico, they will always be sterile. And that's why you cannot breed a calico.
So if you're one of those people who has their mind set on having a female cat, if you go for a calico, odds are you will have a female. They will, most vets, when we brought Maya in the first time to the vet when she was little, immediately looked into the carrier and was like, oh, okay, well, that's gonna be a female. Just the same as most gingers are actually male. Not as strongly as with calicos, but there's also a genetic mutation there. And it's due to the fact that they're more likely to have the two X chromosomes. And as Toby said, therefore, because the males are sterile, you can't actually breed one. And that's what links back to the miracle cat and why you can't breed them, because you can basically just have one calico in the breeding program, and well, then the odds are against you, obviously.
And I think that leads nicely into the next point, and that they are regarded as good luck cats. I don't know if you've I'll put a little photo up, but there's this very popular Japanese cat.
It's called a greeting cat and a beckoning cat, I believe. So it's the little statues that are often in storefronts and in houses that waves and is considered good luck and is considered to bring money into the household, I believe, as well.
And I know in German they're also known as good luck cats, Glückskatzen. So,
which means lucky cat. And in Japan they're really highly regarded. I know that they also take them along on fishing boats because they're supposed to bring luck to fishermen. So maybe Toby should take Maya on his fishing trips.
Yeah, I'm sure she will love that.
So especially in Japan, there's a lot of, not really mythology, but a lot of symbolism surrounding calicos. That they are the cat you want to have if you want to have a lucky life, if you want to have money in life, and so on and so forth. And I think, again, that links back to the fact that they are little miracles, because you never know when you're going to get one. And the last, but not least, calicos kind of have this reputation for having very strong personalities, which is weird, because they are available in a lot of breeds, so technically they should take on the personality traits of each breed. But from what we've heard from other people and the research we did, it seems that calicos are very quirky and they like to have like their little behaviors that are very like independent and very sassy, and maybe they just know that they're worshipped and that they're lucky and they can get away with everything. And Maya will do that too. She is by far the cuddliest cat we have, and not just that, she will insist on you cuddling her. So if we sit on the couch, she will like climb into our faces to get the cuddles. And
yeah, and she is a little bit difficult at times. I mean, she is the most cuddly, but she also gives us the most hassle with what food she wants. She's very picky. We'll make a video about this as well. We're starting them all on raw foods. If you've followed us on Instagram, you'll see. And she's always been very picky with these kind of things, so we hope we can get her converted successfully to raw food as well.
She's definitely the one we're the most worried about, because she knows what she wants, and if she doesn't want it, she'll just leave it.
I think right now she doesn't want this camera in her face anymore.
She'll also, if we compare to the other cats, if we do pick up when she doesn't want to, she will moan like there's no tomorrow, like we have personally offended her. She will sound really, really upset.
Yeah, she's also by far the loudest. Like, Momo will talk a lot, but
it's very dainty.
Yeah, but she will really make her presence known if she doesn't want to be touched or bothered or stuff.
Yeah, she's very hot and cold. She'll be like, one moment she'll be all in your face wanting love, and then the next she'll be like, leave me alone, don't touch me.
And she's special, as you can see how she's lying here. I mean, I don't even know how that's comfortable. Hey, Maya.
But in general, calicos are fantastic. They are such beautiful cats as well, and they're so unique. And as a designer, I generally prefer cats that are very
symmetrical
and very sleek in their looks and so on, because it's just something that appeals to me. But funnily enough, I think that in calicos it actually works so well that they're asymmetrical, because it just, like, even Maya, if you look at her right now in her face, she does have the symmetrical point that goes through her forehead, and then she has the black dots that aren't symmetrical, and it just, she kind of looks like a koi fish. If that's a weird analogy to make, but I think that, like, it's really, they're quite beautiful in their
weirdness,
in their weird patterns. Because it's not as with tortoiseshell, it's just like muddled into, the colors kind of muddle into one another. With calicos, it's nearly more like cows, where they have patches, and it makes them weirdly attractive.
Yeah, well, I don't know if these are all necessarily reasons to adopt a calico, but if you are thinking of adopting a cat, maybe this convinced you to get a calico. I'm sure they're probably one of the easier cats to find at shelters or breeders or whatever.
People might not find them as attractive, but take it from us, they're fantastic cats, and you get three colors of cats all in one.
And like 10 personalities in one.
So if you have any stories and other fun facts about your calicos, please pop them into the comments. We always love to hear about your cats and your stories.
And then remember to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any future uploads. And go find us on Instagram. We post there, it's more on a regular daily basis, sharing stories and stuff like that, and little updates of all the cats, our little clowder that we have here. And then we'll check you in the next one. Cheers.
Bye.